Guys, let me warn you for something. Don't be sending me this kind of long message. How am I supposed to read this one now? Hello, D. Uden Kobo Gwe Pistu. Who want to read all this one now? The shake way for you. Hello, Afana. Akilo Sele. Episode 3. Ah. My God. I know you like my studio. Thanks for the compliment. We have so much madman question today. Like, question that can make somebody go crazy. It's gonna be very crazy, I swear down. So yeah, in case you are just watching for the first time, welcome to my show. Real Life Matters Episode 3, the only program where you can ask different questions about your life and relationship. But unfortunately, most people have been asking us questions about, you know, that thing. Then other question about relationships are just boys and girls thing. Don't the people have other problems? Nobody asks about education. Nobody asks about chasing dreams, you know, how you want to become somebody important in life apart from that person that want to feature me. Yeah. So don't you guys have other questions to ask somebody? I'm getting bored of all these bad questions because I'm a good guy on a normal day as Oshomo now. So anyway, we don't talk too much, straight to the point. Question number one. Yeah bro, I've been having problems so far with concentration. I cannot concentrate in school, games, anything. I really need your help. Bro, I don't know what the problem is, but I feel like you need to sort out where this challenge is coming from. You need to check your family, you need to check. What are you thinking about? What is not making you to concentrate? Oh, boy, you didn't have enough breast milk growing up. I don't know. If it's a girl you are thinking about, you need to minimize it. I don't know. If it's your family something, you need to sort it out first then. But if it's just a normal problem, but you cannot concentrate, I would advise you to see your doctor or go and get injection in your brain so that you can concentrate better. I personally, I cannot concentrate, but I don't care. As long as it have nothing to do with rap music. I can just be dropping my single anyhow, you know. Concentration, blah, blah. Who concentration help? No, tell me. You tell me. Answer the question yourself. Who the concentration help? Exactly. So just move on with your life. Or go and see your doctor and, you know, do some check-up. You might be having mental problem. But that is actually not a funny situation. I'm so sorry for that. But anyway, you need to see your doctor and, yeah. Hi, Tafik. I'm a big fan of yours. Actually, I'm not here to ask any question, but to just praise you for your works. Wow, Shiri. I'm a rock player fan. I couldn't say it. But done. I see you. Shout out to you. Hey, I'm 16 and I have a lot of problems. My mom, oh my God, this is a long story. If you want to check it out, if you feel like you can reply the person, the message will be on this side. You know, you can read everything. Yeah. But from what I can see, it's like you're having a lot of issues. But you want to chase your career and you want to do something that people love. Since you are good at 3D animation, you know, acting, cinematography, anything. Since you are good at it, start something, you know, even if it's with your phone. Do some animation stuff, you know, make people laugh, make people entertain. You don't even need to be a comedian. Sometimes you just need to look for situations that are really happening around you and just send out some positive vibes out there. Let people engage in what you are doing. You get me? And you don't have to be the best at what you are doing. Just make sure that you are doing it right and you have the passion for it. Something that okay, they wake you up at 2 a.m. in the night, but like, what's a 3D animation? You will do it straight down with no problem. So just put your skills to work, you know. Get involved in something and make sure, this is the problem now. You don't just do whatever you like, you need to make sure, but whatever you are doing is what people want to see, you know? Make people engage with your stuff, you get me? Like me, I'm a very good artist, there's no way I drop my music, people always. Sorry I'm bothering you with my music, but yeah, music is life, you get me? So yeah, just involve people, sha, and you will blow up, I swear down. Tafik Baba, I couldn't say that, gone, but I don't know why, brother. Look, man, I've been into comedy, but lack of support, lack of views, equipment, yeah, materials, it's pulling me down big time. So how do you think I can get rid of this feeling, bro? Bro, you don't need equipment. You don't need anything. Honestly, if you go back and check my first video, you know that all this thing I'm using right now, I didn't just get it. All swing, you know. You just keep pushing, keep pressing. Start something. You should have a phone. You are using phone to email me, innit? And obviously, it's not another phone or Nokia 3310. It's confirmed phone you are using, I'm sure. Because you're on IG, you can check my video and all this thing. So start with your phone, you know, record something or do whatever you like. Just record something and start from there. There are some skits I shoot with my phone that you cannot know that you are even booyah, you are thinking that okay, this video I use. Like this video I shoot for this video now. That video was done on phone, but you cannot believe it. Exactly. So you need to take your time, focus on what you need. What you need right now as starting up, you need content and you need people to click on your content, innit? So just start out with something, you will get there, just keep growing, and don't be lazy, be consistent. Somebody like me, I'm beyond consistent with my music, and as you can see, people are no more fucking with my music, you get, but we are coming with a straight banger soon. So remain consistent and just keep pushing forward, you will get there, believe me. Yeah, And if you like, don't give yourself brain, maybe you get 2K followers, you start doing that whole shit. Continue there. You think, oh, we have babes everywhere, things everywhere. I mean, I'm not a celeb, or then yeah, you are a fool. But I remember people that have 1 million and all that thing. It did not add anything to their bank account, too. So go front and brain. You just go there, boy. Oshamo, I see the hot. Oh, yeah, shop knuckle. Kuro, or there. You say you want to shop knuckle. Go and face your career, Joe. Guys, let me warn you for something. Don't be sending me this kind of long message. How am I supposed to read this one now? I will reply you at my own free time, but if you cannot come straight to the point in 2-5 lines, we don't want your email, Abi. You guys cannot talk, ne?
Yes.
Yeah, we don't want your email if it's too long. Are you the pastor, ne? Hello, day. We don't come go a piece too. Who want to read all this one now? They shake way for you. Anyway, let's try and read this fast fashion. So I recently moved to the country. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, I recently moved into a country. And normally I feel guys are a waste of time. You guys have to listen to this one. Your ear is going to pain you, but you need to listen. It's so long. I decided to date this guy. It wasn't at all. I didn't even have feelings for him, but I just wanted to know what it felt like dating someone. My experience was horrible. He was a child. Always wanted me to be with him. He always wanted PDA, which was annoying. I understand that he wants me to show off in public because most guys at my school look at me, but they don't come up to me. But because of my ex, I pray in church that whenever I walk by any guy this school year, they shouldn't notice me. They should only feel breeze. Claudia, are you a winch? They should not see you. How come I feel? I feel fine. How come I blow last night? Let's get to the bottom of this, yeah? Anyway. But I guess I didn't pray hard enough. And there are other guys that want to make a move, but I don't talk to most people at my school. I keep my circle small so they don't know how to get me. I don't care about turning the athletes down in a mean way because all they want is someone to smash. And I can't do that, but there is this other guy. He's new, not like the others. So my question is, how do I tell him no? Oh, I think she means, and I cannot do that. Only bon with she. How do I tell him no in a nice way because I'm not a nice person? Ah. Auntie, you can say this to the whole public, but you are not a nice person. But you want nice guys. Wow. So first of all, she says somebody always wanted PDA. For those of you that didn't know the meaning of PDA, because I know that most of you watching this thing, you are illiterate, but we will lecture you. Meaning of PDA. PDA is public display of affection, Abby. Yeah. Like kissing, smushing, you know, pressing Bobby in public. All those kind of things. Yeah. That is the meaning. Don't ask me how I know about it. I'm a showman now. What do you expect? This auntie didn't like public display. It's like she's a mojesu. She's a very good decent girl. But she's looking for a good boy and she cannot see good boy. First of all, auntie, you cannot pray to God, but a boy should not see you now. That is a very bad thing. Say you want to reach 40 without marrying eh? No, let's tell ourselves the truth now. How you go to church? I'm saying, God, Oluwa, I don't want any guy to see me today. Make them blind. They're going to follow you, break their eyes, remove their eyeball. That is what you are saying now. And the good guy might be there, but because you have Badura, AJ Michael will just slap his face. We might go redouble. When you pass by, he cannot even notice you only praise. And then first of all, guys might be shit. I've dated many girls that are shit. Like, when I'm talking about shit, I'm talking about shit multiplied by shit raised to power shit. There are people like that are shit, trust me. Walk bogan. But in the midst of all these shit people, they are also good people. So you cannot be going to church and be praying to God, but God should not let you see somebody that is interested in you. That is not a good prayer. In fact, if I'm God, Neil, I will slap your face because you are making a wrong choice. You should be happy when guys are approaching you, whether for your quality or no quality or for your nyash or anything, front, back, be happy. But what is your approach, you know? Bad way, you are emotional, you are hot. So, first of all, you need to correct that notion in your brain. You need to make yourself know that, okay, people should like you, people should be able to approach you. Even though some will not approach you for the good reason, some will approach you for the good reason, but be open-minded. Don't be closed-minded like a mogul. Give yourself brain. Then after that, you need to open your eyes. How do you tell a guy that you don't want sex in marriage? Or, first of all, this is one thing. If you are looking to preserve yourself to the day of marriage or after marriage or when you die finish, let your boyfriend know from the beginning. You don't have to be saying no when he's asking you. You need to let him know, but okay, well, boyfriend, I like you, I love you so much. This affection is 100%, but I didn't want to sleep with you, you know, because I'm a good child. I like to preserve my body, you know. Then let him know, right from the start. Not that you date for 5 years, he would have buy you Gucci bag, buy you motor, build that for you. And I'll be telling him, well, you cannot give the p-. Are you crazy? I'm a nice guy, I can still let you go. Even if I've treated you nice, but you don't want to, you know, I can still let you go because I'm a nice person. I'm a nice person, yeah. But other guys are not the same, they will beat your life. You need to let them know straight from the beginning, okay, bros, I like you, you're a sweet guy, but we cannot sleep together because I'm a child of God. And you are going to find someone that fits you, you know, someone you can pray with, someone you can meditate on, you know, do things together in a godly way. So number one, you need to let people approach you. You need to be approachable. Change your character. Be a good person by all means. Trust me, someone like me now, if I make other people smile, I'm happy deep down, you get me? If I make other people feel my jams, like, okay, my bedu is fire. I'm so happy deep down because why? I put smile on somebody's face. I make somebody happy. So it's contagious, Abi. How do you speak that English? It's anyone. Ocean man contact ya. So yeah. So when you do good to other people, it reflects in your life. It's not a blessing thing, it's just natural. It's something that follows the universe. Once you are good to people, good will come back to you. Once you are bad to people, bad will come back to you in multiple fold. So yeah. First of all, embrace positivity, then yeah, that's it. Hi, my name is I have a boyfriend, we've been together since 2012, but we never have sex because I told him I'm a virgin. But I knew him as someone that cannot stand such situation, but he promised, and since then I never caught him shit. I laugh in Spanish, but I never caught him shit, but of course, I knew he does. I traveled to the country in 2015. Which he still promised to wait for. He cannot wait! Bros! Mbo, you are waiting. Have you want Shango to punish you? Oh, yeah, like, swear to God, but you didn't have sex when she travel. No, swear, just swear. You cannot swear now. You say you don't want your life to destroy. Anyway, back to the email, Jerry, which he promised to wait for me. We talk sometimes because it's not constant with phone. Number one sign. Except that he's a busy person, but he's not busy. Number one sign. He's not constant with his phone. Always have one problem or the other. To cut off the story short, he started shitting with my best friend. Now you are talking. I don't understand why girls say somebody shitting with their best friend. He's not your best friend. You are not friend before. You just want your man prick. That's all. Best friend, babu. I don't make friends, but I have this very one person. My siblings confirm it and my mom. What should I do? And I don't want to be an ingrate. Please hide my identity. I plead you. Okay. So what do you want to look for now? Is it you want to still be making friends or you still want to date the guy? I don't know, but I will give you answer to the both question. Number one thing, run away from that guy. Run to the mountain. Just be running away. Like I say, it's your choice. If you don't want to give the boy your body, good. And if you want to give him, it's your choice. But since it's you don't want to give him, fine. Run away. Go and look for boys in other churches. Deeper Life, CAC. Boy that can fast with you, pray with you. Boy that you will stay with him for 2 million years and will not shit on you. You will be calling, if possible, say, unscrew it something, and parlock it somewhere, so that you cannot carry it. I don't know if they can do that one, but anyway. Run away from the boy, break up, Dano. That's the end of Mr. Lagbaja that is shitting with you, out of the building. Now, next person, your best friend. Number one thing, don't let me deceive you, I will not even deceive you this time around. Give yourself brain. She's not your best friend, number one thing. I have one best friend, this idiot. If he sleep with my girlfriend, I will kill him first before we even disfriend ourselves. I will pardon him now, but I know he cannot do it. That's what I'm talking about. So somebody that can even stay around your boyfriend without feeling bad. Here you see me like this. If I see my boyfriend babe. If I see my friend babe, I cannot come close to you. I will stay like 5 kilometers. I'll be saying, good evening, man. How are you? Nice meeting you. I cannot come close to you because I don't want to cause problem. You get me? If I'm the one in your shoe, I will shoot my best friend in the head, honestly. But don't do that because you are not me. Anyway, but she's not your best friend. Cut the relationship. Curry. This bitch, you way too low, show you need to curry. Out of the building. That's it. Just stay on your own. You don't need to have best friends. You know, you can have people that you are rolling with, people that are close to you, but never make them your best friend. You are the only best friend you can have is yourself. You get me? I know you will not understand it until you are like 50 years old, but yeah, true talk. And I think you should spend more time with your family more. Someone like me, I roll with people that have really been there for me when I need them. You get? People that have really done something for me in my life. I don't just see someone today and say, oh, you have a fine, cute face. You are my best friend. No, you need to have impact on my life. So, except she have donate blood for you or remove her kidney for you or remove her, I don't know, in case you have flat something, I should remove her and borrow you. You can remain best friend. But if not, she's not your best friend. Go and focus on your life, auntie. If you try another option and it didn't work for you, don't come and complain, because I've given my advice now. Give yourself brain. Go to your fast super. Nice meeting you. I hope you listen, Sha. Next question. Why are you all of you writing so much long message? Have we stopped this show? And yeah, twice I should give shout out to these people. Ogboyemi Setu, Thomas Olawale, Ekeni Meita. I don't know how to pronounce your name, but you know your name, Sha. Yeah, shout out to you. And Linda Adeleke, shout out to you too. You say I should give three people shout out, but two people have, you know, seven likes together. And, you know, I just have to be fair with it. So yeah, shout out to you guys. Shop Knuckle. Shop the Knuckle, Sha. We'll be right back.